Good morning, children. Today we are going to see a new chapter, which is playing with numbers. Now, as a first topic, we are going to see factors. Factors is nothing but representation of a number in multiplication. Okay, for example, you have seen in your previous class about the addition, framing a problem, right? In that, what you will do, you will have a sum, for example 40, then you will frame a question for that. For example, 20 plus 20, that will give you 40, right? This you did in addition. Likewise, we are going to do it in multiplication. For example, let's say you have a number 4. You can write this as 1 into 4 or 4 into 1 or 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4, right? So this is how you do it. You represent a number in terms of numbers with multiplication. For example, let's say you have a 6 stones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are so many ways that you can arrange this one. For example, you can arrange the stones in straight line, only one row. So only one row, which is how many number of rows will be 1, and so total number of balls is 1 2 3 4 5 6. You have one row, in that one row you have 6 balls. Okay, likewise you can do it, you can arrange this in 2 rows. So you have one row and 2 row, which means number of rows is 2 and total number of balls will be, see, here you have one row and here you have second row. 2 into how many balls in one row? 1, 2 and 3. 3. So 2 into 3 will be 6. You can arrange this in another terms also, like 3 rows. So you have 3 rows, which means number of rows is 3, number of balls is 3 rows into 1 and 2, 2 balls in a row, so into 2, 2 threes are 6. Or you can arrange this as 1 1 1 in each row, which means number of rows is 6 and total number of balls is 6 into 1 on each row, so 1, which means 6. From this you can see there are so many factors for 6. Here you can arrange, you can say that 1 into 6 equal to 6, 2 into 3 equal to 6, 3 into 2 equal to 6, 6 into 1 equal to 6. So these are called factors of 6, which are called 1, 2, 3 and 6. These are all factors of 6. We can represent all numbers in factors of numbers. For example, if you have 5, you can represent this as 1 into 5, right? So 1 and 5 will be the factors of 5. If you have 8, then you can say 1 into 8, then 2 into 4, right? And 8 into 1, 4 into 2, which means 1, 2, 4 and 8 will be the factors of 8. So remember, this factor is nothing but mathematical expression of a number in terms of other number with multiplication. Okay, so let's see what are the properties of fractions. Okay, so we'll start with the first property. What is first property? Whenever you see a number, for example 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you can go on telling all the numbers. If you see them, you can say 1 can be written as 1 into 2. 3 can be written as 1 into 3. 4 can be written as 1 into 4. 5 can be written as 1 into 5. 6 can be written as 1 into 6. If you look at all these, you can find one thing common, which is 1. So we can come to the conclusion that 1 is factor of all numbers. So you can express any number with 1. Second one, this gives us that if you multiply 1 with that number, you will get a number. For example, if you multiply 1 with 5, you will get 5. That means that number is also factor of the same number. For example, 5 is a factor of 5, 8 is a factor of 8. For 1 into 8, which means 8 is a factor of 8, or 10, 1 into 10, which means 10 is a factor of 10. All numbers are factor of themselves. This is the second property. So third property will be if you have 15, so if you divide 15 by 15, you will get remainder as 0 and quotient as 1. So every number is their exact division. Division means if you divide, for example, if you divide 4 with 4, 4 ones are quotient, this is quotient. 4 ones are 4 and 0, which means all the numbers are exact divisions of themselves. If you divide 10 with 10 1 times, you will get 0, which means they are all divisors of themselves. Okay. So now we are going to see fourth property, which is, let's say you have 6. What are the factors of 6? 1, 2, 3 and 6. When you look at these factors, you can see one thing. 1 is less than 6, 6 less than 6, 2 is less than 6, 3 is less than 6, and 6 is equal to 6, which means all the factors are less than or equal to 6. For let's say 5. What are the factors of 5? 1 and 5. 1 is less than 5 and 5 is equal to 5, which means all the factors are less than or equal to the numbers. So next one will be, okay, so you can say that numbers are infinite. If you take 10 lakh, you can say this is bigger number, but if you add another 0 here, then it becomes greater number. If you have another zero, it will go on increasing. Numbers has no limits. But when it comes to factors, you can say that factors are limited. If you look at, for example, if you take 10,000, you can say the factors can be 1, 2, 4 and 10,000 and so on. But they will be finite. You will say the number of factors, a number as is limited. Okay. So that is the fifth property of factors. So the sixth property is multiplication. You have learned in tables, right? For example, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Okay, so 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. So if you see, 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 2 is 4, 2 3s are 6, which means they are increasing. With the number increases, they are increasing, which means multiples are increasing. Either they can be the same number. If you multiply the number 2 with 1, you'll get 2. 2 with 2, you'll get 4. If you go on increasing, the number will go on increasing. Okay. So, they can either be the number or greater than number. They cannot be smaller because we are multiplying, which means they won't decrease, only they will increase. Okay, so let's say they are increasing, will they stop? You can always multiply with another number which will get bigger and bigger. So there are no limits for multiplies. You can go on multiply until or unless you get tired, because there are so many numbers with which you can multiply, keep on going. But factors are not like that. Factors will get, they are limited and they will get stopped after certain numbers. Okay, so the last property, sixth property, is multiplying numbers will increase the number. They will either be the number or greater than the given number, they won't be lesser. And seventh property is they have multiplies have no limits. They will keep on going, you can keep on adding them. And then the eighth property, which is you can say 7 into 1 equal to 7, 8 into 1 equal to 8, 9 into 1 equal to 9. So you can keep on go on saying that every number is multiple of themselves. They can be written as multiple of themselves. So every number is multiple of themselves. With this, we get to a conclusion of properties of factors. So, last, for your information, I'm going to tell you one thing. So, here you have, let's consider the number 6. What are the factors of 6? 1, 2, 3 and 6. Add this all numbers. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. So, here. If you see 12, you can say this is double times of 6. 6 twos are 12, right? such numbers. If you add the factors of the numbers, and it will give you the double of the number. Such numbers are called perfect numbers. If you add all the factors of the number, they will give you twice of the number. Such numbers are perfect number. Another example for perfect number is 28. Here you can say 1 is a factor, 2 is a factor, 4 is a factor, and 14, 7 and 28. These are the factors of 28. So 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 14 plus 28. How much? 1 plus 2 will be 3, 3 plus 4 will be 7, 7 plus 7 is 14, 14 plus 14 is 28, 28 plus 28 will be 56. So you can see 56 is double the number of 28. So if you add all the factors and if you get double the number of number which we consider, then they are called perfect number. Okay. So now we are going to find factors of 68. So first we have to see, it is constant for every number 1 into 68. We have to write 1 into that number will always give you that number. Okay. Next, this is can be divided by 2 because all even numbers can be divided by 2. So now 68 divided by 2. 2 threes are 6 and 2 fours are 8, which means they are 2 into 34 will give you 68. Right. Next, now you can see 34. This 34 can be divided by 2. So now what we are going to do is divide 68 by 4. 4 ones are 4. 6 minus 4 will be 2 and 8. 4 fives are 20, 4 sixes are 24, 4 sevens are 28. Which means 4 into 17 equal to 68. There is a secret for finding whether a number can be divisible by 3. What you have to do is you have to add these two numbers. Okay, for example, this 68 your number, right? Add 6 plus 8. 6 in your mind, 8 in your finger. 6 after 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14. You got again 2 digit number. Add this 2. 4 plus 1 will be 5. Can 5 be divisible by 3? No, right? So 68 cannot be divided by 3. So now we got all the factors we can find. And if you have 0 or 5 in the end, you can say that that number can be divisible by 5. Okay. So the factors are 1, 2, 4, 17, 34 and 68. This is how you find factors of a number. So let's see this number. So 36, this is an even number, so this can be divided by 2. First you have to write 1 into 36 equal to 36. Second one, 36 divided by 2. 2 ones are 2, 3 minus 2 will be 1, 6. So 2 eights are 16. You can write 2 into 18 equal to 36. 18 can be divided by 2, right? So we are going to divide 36 by 4. 4 nines are 36. We have learned in the table. So 4 into 9 equal to 36. So this is 6. So we cannot divide this by 5. Now we are going to see whether we can divide this by 3.
3 plus 6
is 3 in your mind, 6 in your finger. 3 after 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 can be
divided by 3, right?
So, which means 36 can be divided by 3.
So now,
36 divided by 3.
3 ones are 3. Then 3 twos are 6.
So,
3 into 12 equal to 36.
So, we'll write down the factors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 12, 9, 18 and 36. These are the factors of 36.
This is how we are finding the factors.
Next one. They have asked us to
example 3. They have asked us to
write the next 5 multiples of 6, which means write first 6 5 multiples of 6.
1 6 are 6, 2 6 are 12, 3 6 are 18, 4 6 are 24, 5 6 are 30.
So these are the next 5 multiples of 6.
6, 12, 18, 24, 30.
Okay. So now we are going to find the factors of 24. 24 can be divided by 2.
So 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4.
Which means first 1 into 24, then 2 into 12, then
you can divide 12, right? So 4, 24. So 4, 6 are 24.
This will be 4 into 6, and 6 can again be divided by 2. So
you can divide 24 by 8.
8 fours are 8 threes are 24. Next. So what are the factors? 1, 2, 4, 3, 6, 8, 24. You just have to divide them and find their factors. 15.
1 into 15, 3 into 5.
Right. So 1, 3, 5, 15, 21. 1 into 21, 3 into 7, which means 1, 3 and 7. Find the rest of the factors which they have given you. Now they have asked us to find
next 5 multiples of
5, 8 and 9. These are all nothing but tables. You just have to find the first 5 values of the table and then write. Okay. So the last question will be, match the following. So first they have given 35, 15, 16 and 20. 25. So they have given you the answers to match. First one, multiple of 8. Multiple of 7, 70, factor of 30, factor of 50, factor of 20. So first, see, when you can see, now see, first you have 35. Here you have 8 can never be as odd numbers. See, odd numbers are nothing but I'll explain you in the next class. So 35, let's see. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40. So 35 is not there. So 35 cannot be multiple of 8. So here multiple of 7. 7 table, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, 7 fours are 28, 7 fives are 35, which means 35 is multiple of 7. Then now we have 70 here. So we are going to find for 15. If you multiple 8, 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. So 8 cannot be multiple of 15. Now 70. If you say the 15 tables, you won't find 70, which means, so see, 70 is greater than 15, which means if you multiply 70, you will get greater number, not smaller number. So 15 cannot be multiple of 70. Okay, so next, factor of 30. If you multiply 15 into 2 times, then you will get 30. So 15 is factor of 30. Now we have 16. Starting multiple of 8. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, which means multiple of 8 is 16. Now we have 20. Multiple of 70. 20 is still lesser than 70, so 20 cannot be multiple of 70. For a multiple to be greater than the given number, if 70, then we have to see multiple of 70s are, which means 1 into 70, 70, 2 into 70, 140. Which means for a number to be multiple of 70, it should be greater than 70 or equal to 70. 20 is not greater or equal to 70. None of these are greater or equal to 70. So we can eliminate these options first. Next, 20. Factor of 50 or factor of 20. You can see 20. Every number is factor of themselves. So 20 is factor of 20. Now we have factor of 50. That is the only left option, but then also we will check. If you divide 50 by 2, you will get 2 twos are 4, 1, 0, 2 fives are 10, which means 25 is factor of 50. This is how you match the answers. So write the answers, okay. 35 is multiple of 7, 15 is factor of 5, 16 is multiple of 8, 20 is multiple of factors of 20, 25 is factor of 50. Okay, in the next class we will see about prime and composite numbers, odd and even numbers, everything. Okay, see you in the next class. Bye.